graves will open and the dead in Christ will rise. All of the dead, the graves will give up the dead. Even those who died in the middle of the ocean. Even those who were burnt. Even those who were buried alive in an earthquake. Whatever be it. Even those who lost their lives in outer space. Because the rockets blew up. All of them will rise again. When you've crossed over from death to life spiritually, you will cross over from death to life literally also. When you cross over from death to life while you are still alive, you will cross over from death to life to eternal life with Jesus, even if you die. Amen. And the beauty of Christian life is not living by a set of beliefs that does not clarify our fate or our future. We are not living a life which does not give us a clarity about the future, but we have a Christian life. We live this Christian life which gives us a clear understanding about our future, our eternity, what happens after we die. But a truth that is strong, this is a truth that is strong and solid as a rock that has already made us to cross over from death to life. It is not that you have to wait and watch and see what this God might do or not do. Will I have eternal life? Because of all of that I have done in this world, will I make it or not make it? What is written on my forehead, I don't know. What is my fate? What was my previous birth, I don't know. And what will be my next birth, I do not know. And where will I go? And when will I one day become one with God? I don't know. It's not an unsure faith. And even after I have kept all the tenets of the faith, I do not know finally that God, who is some supreme being up there, will have to decide by fate. And maybe if he decides that I have been really good and favorable to him, maybe he might give me some 70 virgins in heaven. It's not that kind of a faith. It's not some kind of a fluid thing, something, a cloudy thing, but it's something that is very certain and very clear, which you will, when you give your life over to the truth of scriptures, and when you go through this struggle and overcome the struggle and willingly give your life to Jesus and begin to, you know, have his teachings dwell in your hearts and begin to live by it and renounce everything that is falsehood, what begins to happen is that you cross over from death to life in this world itself while you're still alive. Hallelujah! You and I as a child of God have crossed over from death to life while you are still alive. And because of that, you know you will cross over even if you literally die. Hallelujah! Amen! Why do I say even if you literally die? Sounds like there's a benefit of doubt given to that statement whether you will die or not. Why? Because when Jesus, if Jesus comes in our lifetime, we may not experience physical death. Then we can say we were immortal on earth. This is a new false teaching that is going around that you, if you believe, you will not face physical death at all. That's not what the Bible is talking about. It's appointed for man to die once and then the judgment. If there is a birth, there is a But the truth is this, that if you have crossed over from death to life while you're still alive, while you've spiritually crossed over from death to life, you are not going to be condemned, and you can be absolutely sure that even if you die, you are going to cross over from death to life, because the graves will open up and the dead in Christ will receive life because of the good that they have done, because of the life that they have lived. Hallelujah. Amen. We know that in our hearts. We are not condemned because we are justified by the blood of Jesus, because he has broken every chain. Hallelujah. Amen. We sang that song which said, you know, we are under the power. There's power in the name of Jesus. This is the power in the name of Jesus. He breaks every chain of sin and curse and all of the consequences of sin and breaks the chain of death and eternal damnation and makes us to cross over from death to life into an eternal life where we will literally be resurrected from the dead to be with Jesus forever. And so is the assurance of resurrection, to live and enjoy the rewards of living a good life on this earth, in this world. Not a fearful, dark, uncertain, unknown end. The question is, are you living a good life in Christ? Do you do good works? Is there good fruit that's coming out of your life? If you believed you cross over from death to life, you're going to be living as one who has the life of Christ in you. Because the Bible says it's no longer I who lives, but Christ lives in me. If any man is in Christ, he's a new creation. The old is gone, the new has come. The new life in Christ has begun. Are you living a good life? Are you living like Christ? And if you have crossed over from death to life, you will live like Jesus. You will love like Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. The fruit of Jesus being in your life will begin to manifest naturally. There will be a natural outcome of the life of Jesus through you. But are you able to see that? And if you're able to see that, and if you're saying in the last 8 months, now we are in the 9th month of this year, in the last 8 months, I have crossed over more and more to become like Christ, and the Christ life of Christ is beginning to reflect through my life more and more. I'm beginning to see more and more outcomes. The nature and the life of Christ through me. That's the Christian life all through this life in this world. You begin to reflect Jesus on a day-to-day basis in the way you live and by the outcomes of your life. What kind of fruit are you producing? Are you convinced in your heart that you certainly will experience bodily resurrection and receive your due reward even if you die in this world? Amen? Hallelujah. So Jesus is calling us this morning to take a giant leap and cross over from death to life. And when you do that, you're going to cross over from the grave to life. Amen. Hallelujah. That's the privilege of a child of God. And that's something which involves a decision. That involves a commitment. That involves pursuing the truth. That involves, you know, hearing the voice of God. If you hear the voice of God while you are alive in this world, you will hear the voice of God even if you are dead. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You will hear the voice of God. Even the dead will hear the voice of God. And they will live and they will be with Jesus eternally. This is the hope. This is the great crossing over. Amen. And that's why Jesus came. That's why he crossed over from heaven to earth. That's why he crossed over, you know, from putting on humanity, taking upon himself humanity and leaving behind all the glories of heaven. He came into the sinful world and he crossed over. He crossed over from death to life for your sake so that you and I can also cross over from death to life. Amen. But it all depends on the decision you make this morning. The question is this: are you having the outcomes of this new life that you live in Christ? If Christ is living in you, if you've crossed over from death to life, and you know that Jesus lives in you, let's look at your life. Let the people look at your life. We sang this morning, shine your light, and let the whole world see the glory of the risen King. How prophetic these songs were. And so much alignment to the scriptures that the Lord is giving us this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Let the Lord shine his light through us so that the world will see the glory of the risen King. Amen. There is something that has been deposited in you which is so precious, which is so powerful, which is so glorious, which is so rich, which is so wonderful, which is so beautiful. You think your life is worth nothing. Maybe people have told you that your life is worth nothing. Maybe many times you thought, why did I even come into this world? Why was I even born? Why did my mother give me birth? But I want you to know Because God loves you so much. He's given you so much to you. He's considered you so worthy. So valuable. So precious. He foreordained you. He thought about you. He planned about you. He wants you to experience this newness, this new life in Him. And that's why He has brought you here. That's why you're hearing what you're hearing. Because He wants you to cross over from death to life. And He wants you to cross over from the grave to life, literally also. Not only that, He has now given you this message so that you can help others cross over from death to life. And help people take this giant leap. Amen. And so this evening, as we're going to come together, we're doing this so that we will help people cross over. Amen. Nothing else. There's no other purpose. It's not for name. It's not for fame. It's not for money. It's not for anything else. We don't want people to stay where they are, but we want them to cross over to eternal life and experience the resurrection from the dead one day. Amen.